There was plenty of drama in the early stages of the wakeboard contest as riders battled through the heats, the early exits feeling as brutal as yesterday's weather.
Well, what a difference a day makes. The cyclone that was north of here, just up beyond Geraldton, hit the shore, bounced along the shoreline, and we were really worried we'd be blown out. But here we are, this is Sunday finals day, and we're looking at the water, and it really looks very, very good right now.
Again, the stage had been set for two world-class finals, featuring 12 of the biggest names in the sport. The six women will be on the water first, who, after the semis, gave their view on who had the best podium chance.
Obviously, Raimi Merritt, who's here, rides so good every time in rough conditions, so she's definitely probably the biggest threat right now. And then Nicola Butler, Beck Gange, like, as usual, everyone is here so good, so it'll be interesting to see.
Beck Gange, you know, over the last couple years, she's really come up and really made a name for herself, and she won the World Cup stop a couple years ago, so she's definitely one of the top girls. And also, Nicola Butler's here. She's been on the World Cup for the last couple years as well, and it's definitely going to be interesting.
Australian rider and 2013 Mandura winner Beck Gange was again a local favourite after having had a great 2014.
Yeah, it's been awesome. Last year I had a really good year. I won the WWA Worlds, which was pretty awesome and definitely a highlight of my career. I made some podiums at the other World Cup stops. Became Female Trick of the Year in 2014. So yeah, it's just been crazy and really looking forward to 2015.
It's time to head dockside as we join Matt Crowhurst for the women's finals.
The very final day of this Action Sports Games in Mandurah, Western Australia, the host of our fourth ever IWWF Wakeboard World Cup here. And we are getting going with the finals of our ladies. It is Chloe Mills of Australia out on the water, a relatively new face to a finals lineup. She is one of the big names in world wakeboarding, but she's got some tough competition in this final of six, starting off with some beautiful inverts, then a toeside front roll as her third trick. Coming back at the wake, is it going to be a spin? Is she going to go upside down? It is, well, a combination of the two is exactly what she was going for. It is a heelside back roll to blind, so a backside rotation with a handlebars to make it happen, but it didn't quite happen on this occasion. Straight into a second run, a half cab 180 to start things off, then a back roll. So that was the back roll, or the basis of the back roll to blind without the rotation. Are we going to see her have another go at it? No, it's the 540 this time, so getting her spins in, now popping it back round to left foot forward, rounding off this second pass. Heelside stale fish, and that is a solid second run from Chloe Mills. And we crack straight on with Ashley Lugner of Canada coming in. Very nice back roll. So getting the staple tricks in first, just getting into her rhythm. Toe side front roll, not quite enough height, a little bit of a butt check, but getting away from it, ready for her third trick on this first pass. Heelside tantrum. So the exact same flip that you might try on your trampoline at home or into a pool. Obviously do it with supervision, is a tantrum on a wakeboard. Oh, Ashley almost coming into a collision with the speed marker, that massive old pole in the middle of the run. Managing to get round of it, get inside, then get back outside to hit the rail to round off the run. And it's great that we're seeing Ashley hit that feature because it will really bump up her composition points as far as the judges are concerned. Starting off our second run with a rail hit as well, a backside board slide. Toe side front roll again. So a repeat of a trick, perhaps wanting to make it a little bit better. She didn't butt check, but it wasn't quite as big. Heelside, frontside 360. Now that was tidy. That's what the judges like to see. That's what our crowd likes to see, a good mixture. And there is the front roll again. So not quite sure what's happening with Ashley trying that, obviously wanting to go for something else. We move on swiftly at the halfway point now with this young lady. It is Nicola Butler. Always a familiar face in the finals of any contest she enters, and she has taken a top spot at a World Cup before, but not for a while will she change that this weekend. So solid inverts to start things off, getting grabs on that tantrum, looking smooth on that last heelside 360, then coming in left foot forward for a half cab starting switch, landing with her more comfortable right foot forward, coming toe side on to the flat bar, the rail to round off that first pass, as we saw from Ashley, and it's a front side lip slide, making it all the way to the end. The boat disappears under the bridge for a perfect view from the crowd above. It spins round, comes back under the bridge to start off this second pass, and it is the rail that signifies the start of their second run. From that point onwards, the judges are scoring, starting off with a backside board slide into backside lip slide, toe side front roll, little bit ungainly, but she comes away from it. Out wide now on a toe side edge, ready to attack the wake on her heels. The easier way of moving around on the board is the heel side edge. And that was a stalefish. Backhand, heel side edge of the board, in between the boots. Toe side, indie grab. So backhand once again on the toe side edge of the boots, asking for the speed a little bit slower as she rounds off this second pass. And that is two clean stand-up runs with a back roll to finish things off for Nicola Butler. The wild card trick for Nicola Butler of the USA to finish things off on a heel side edge, going for the whirly bird and rides it away. So there we see our first big technical maneuver from the ladies in this final for them. It is a whirly bird, so it's a tantrum, which we've seen from a couple of the girls already, but with an Olay 360, the Olay describing how the rotation actually happens, whipping the handle over the head instead of having to pass it. She can do no more. She is going to be passing on to our next rider, and we move back to Europe. Sweden is on the water. Caroline Gipso, once again, another familiar face in these final lineups, and we will see why that is so, hopefully, in these two passes. A little bit of a butt check. We saw a similar state from the front roll of Ashley Lugner, not quite getting the height, but these girls, they aren't giving up easily, fighting through any wobbles, ready to hit that wake once again. Tantrum coming back at the wake. No, she's going to bide her time. Lovely backside lip slide. Nice and low, only minimal contact with the rail as far as the board is concerned. All the weight on one leg, the judges will like that. So one of our better rail hits so far from Caroline. A little bit bumpy as she comes back into the second pass. She's going for the rail again, front side, lip slide. And once again, putting all of the weight on one leg, pushing the board off the rail as much as she can, making it to the end. Heel side, front side 360, nicely done. Landing down the transition of the second wake, which makes for a much smoother landing. Toe side. Scarecrows, that's the front roll that we've seen from a lot of the girls, but with the 180 on the end of it, nearing the end of this second pass. What can she come up with to put some pressure on the other girls? It is, oh, a beating, which is exactly what Beck Gage thought from that whirly bird of Caroline. That was a heavy fall indeed. She's back up on the water, ready for a wild card trick. Is it going to be the whirly bird again? Yes, it is. And, oh, just about muscling her way through. So she whipped that handle hand really hard to make the rotation, even though she didn't quite get the height she needed. And that's exactly why she didn't land over the second wake. Bit of a casing, but serious skills in managing to muscle that maneuver away. The second of our Australians in this ladies' final now taking to the water, the penultimate of our ladies in this Wakeboard World Cup final for the fourth time in Mandurah, and a former winner of this very event a couple of years ago. Beck Gage out on the water, starting things off on a hillside edge. So Beck knows exactly what she's got to do. The riders who go last within a division, within a heat and within a final, are in the privileged position of being able to know exactly what they need to come up with to get the top spots. Beck looking really comfortable so far. Beautiful scarecrow, beautiful back roll. Those are the first two inverts. Then a heelside 360 getting a little bit off axis the wrong way, avoiding the speed marker, that big old pole, which would cause an incident if we came into collision with it. Toe side 540 to finish. So Beck making the choice of a wake trick over a rail hit for the first pass. Now I believe she is going to go for the rail hit. A seasoned competitor, she knows that this will help her overall composition, and quite apart from that, hitting rails is fun on a wakeboard. It's a big part of what the sport is about. Now we go back to another big part of what the sport is about, where it all started, the wake being the way in which our sport has been named. Wakeboarding out there, and the wake of the boat is what's kicking our girls up into the air. There's a tootsie roll from Beck Gage. So the front roll that we've seen from a few of the girls, but with a backside rotation, one of the more difficult ways of rotating and having to make a handle pass to get it going. It is Raimi Merritt on the water, our final competitor in this ladies division of the Wakeboard World Cup here in Australia. A huge rally to get things going. Then a toe side off axis 540, the first off axis rotation we have seen from any of our girls, asking for the boat crew to slow the speed down a little bit. Lovely nose grab, front side 360 off her heel edge. Almost looked like she went for a second grab on the way out of that, which is very cool indeed. Toe side now, front roll, clean as you like, feet to feet. Oh, and almost coming a cropper right into that rail, managing to stop herself dead before colliding with it, making for a very tidy first run. ready to fight another day, or in this case, fight for another pass. Coming in on the heelside edge, getting onto the horizontal. Nice on the tail, a little bit of a press on that as well. So something slightly different on the rail compared with the other girls. Hopping left foot forward for a half cab, getting a nice bit of height. And I do keep mentioning the height because it's what the judges like to see, a little bit of amplitude. Now we see her using the small handle. You see that little T-bar a little bit up the line from the main handle. She wraps the handle round her back, grabs hold of the T-bar, and that just allows her to make a spin happen in a slightly different way without having to pass the handle hand to hand. Coming back at the wake after those two maneuvers, going for the heelside 540 and not making it happen. That is a shame because that is a slightly more technical trick than we've seen from the other girls who just went for toe side 540s. It is a little bit more difficult, but she went into the rotation too early, didn't get the pop, and so therefore couldn't finish the rotation off. So adding to the tension, as we love to do, this is where it's going to count for Raimi. What can she come up with? It's the S-bend that she's gone for. She manages to ride it away, but a little bit of exasperation there in her expression coming away from that trick. It wasn't the perfect S-bend, but that is going to make things very, very close indeed. Well, between all riders, incredible performances from all six of them, but we may well see the usual names on the podium, but in what order? And that decision is down to our three judges. What they're deliberating is the technicality, the intensity, the composition, how big they went, how difficult it was, and how well varied the run was. And from an outsider's viewpoint, it is going to be a close call indeed, but to make sure that the crowd on the bank who have been waiting with bated breath to see which of our girls are coming out on top know who has come out on top, the decision is going to be announced very shortly, making even more pressure for our judges. And there we have it. It is Nicola Butler taking the top spot. She's always in the mix at these finals, often on the podium, but that is the first top spot for a little while, I believe, getting ahead of Raimi Merritt and Caroline Gipso of Sweden in third.
We have the weather, we got rollers and a lot of wind, so just to stand up with two passes, I was really happy with that. Finally took the win in 2015. I think I've had like 2 seconds and a third out here, so to take the win was really exciting.
Congratulations on a great result.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Mandria Wakeboard 2015 World Cup Champion from the USA, Nicola Butler.